Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to put together an Andonstar AD207S Pro microscope. It has a 10-inch stand and this will be a great addition to my lab. And this will be my gift to Abby. So here's Abby.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm going to be unboxing and putting together a new product from Andonstar. It is their AD207S Pro digital microscope. When I was unboxing it, I was really impressed with how everything was very secured with the styrofoam. Nothing was shifting around or broken. So there's a little screwdriver for putting things together. There was a bug case to look at bugs. They had a light box there, which I'll show you how to use later in the video. A charger to power on. It came with some slides and some tweezers. There's a card that you can put into your microscope. A remote that controls the microscope as well. And here under there is the metal column that will go with your microscope. And on the bottom as well, there is the metal base plate. And here I'm pulling out the HDMI cable. I'm going to pull out the, let's see, that's the USB cable. And I also have a switch cable. There's that base plate. And it's a 10-inch base plate, which is really nice. It has lots of room. And there's our switch cable that will power on and help control the microscope. So here on that metal column, there is a lock ring on the bottom. Go ahead and loosen that lock ring before twisting in the column. So you'll see when you go ahead and twist it, it doesn't twist all the way around right to the front. So you're going to twist it as much as you can and then get it straight into the front. And that's where that lock ring comes into place. You'll tighten it so it's facing straight. And here I am just bending the lights into place. So now you can see that it will go up and down, but I just want to make sure that my lock ring is tightened so the column is facing towards the front, because that's where my microscope is going to go down through, facing down onto the base plate. So something I recognized here was in the manual, it was asking me to put in some screws to this metal column of the base, but my base plate had already had that square part of the metal base at the bottom of the microscope. So you can ignore that part and just screw in the actual metal column, go righty tidy. And then just lock in your lock ring. So then we have these two screws here where your microscope host is going to go down through. So really I just want to lefty loose these till they make enough space for my microscope host to sit down in there until I can tighten them back in. So I thought I had made enough space, but basically I'm just showing you that's where we want our microscope host to sit down in through. So here we have it out of the bag. It looks like it's upside down, right? So let's flip it the right way. But when you look at this way, okay, our microscope is facing the other way. So turn it around and very gently just bend it down so it's facing the right way. And you'll see that it bends. Just don't go too fast or too rough or anything, because it's a very nice piece of equipment. Once we have that, you can put that through the hole where we loosened up our screws. I might have had to loosen mine up a little bit more because I didn't make enough space. It was a little bit bigger than I thought it needed to be, so just lefty-loosey those screws a little bit more. And then once we do that, we'll drop the microscope host through it again. I have my circle for the microscope high enough that the lens will not touch the base, and that's just something you want to always be careful of whenever you're lowering it, is that you don't ever want it to scratch whatever you're looking at or the base plate. All right, so I'm gonna turn it around here just so you can see that once I have it in there, I'm gonna go ahead and righty tidy it back up, and I don't want to screw it in too tight to where it's gonna puncture through any of the lens at all. But now you can see I can move it up and down. My microscope is in place. And that's looking good so far. All right. If you have something that you want to hold in place under your microscope, there are these little clips that come in this kit, which was really cool and awesome. It has a tall screw, and it has a spring and the clip. basically go ahead and stick the screw through the clip and put the spring under it, and there's going to be two holes, as you can see, in the middle of your base. Go ahead and just screw them down in there. I didn't do it too tight because I wanted to be able to see as I lift them up a little bit, just if I need to put anything under there. So I tested it with the booklet that came in the box, and I saw that I was able to put something under there. It held it fine, and then I pulled it out just as a test. So here's that memory card that came with it. You can take it out, and you'll see at the top of your microscope, near the back behind, there's a little slot for it. Go ahead and stick that in there. That will record any kind of pictures or videos you may be taking when looking at something. Now here's where we had that switch cable that I was talking about. There's three wires that come out from it. I spread them all out, the top wire, the middle wire, and the bottom wire. When I looked in my manual, the top wire is going to connect with the main power supply, and the bottom wire is going to go into the base of the board, and you'll see how they match up. And the middle wire is going to go to the USB to power up the microscope. This is that bottom wire where I'm going to go ahead and connect it up with the main power supply, and that's where that charger block comes in handy that they give you. They said that it might power on when you first load it up without pushing the power supply button, so that was normal, and it did happen with me. My lights powered on there, and you might see that it looked black. You can see the one clip there. I just stuck my keys under there to show you that it is on. You can see things. Here is the main board, and this is what we use it here at work for a lot, is to, or at least on my end, I use it a lot. Kevin does a lot more intense things, but on my end, in my office, I use these microscopes to repair the F1 fuse. When we have a printer that blew the main board, the F1 fuse won't power on, or I use these to replace MOSFET transistors, things like that. So you can see that we're getting a really good image here. I'm using the remote control to zoom in, and you're able to zoom back out. I'm using it to brighten the screen right now. I'm using it to darken the screen back down, so if something is too hard to see, you can adjust it. And yeah, it's really nice that it comes with a remote, so you're not having to adjust the actual screen by pushing the buttons and moving around and getting out of focus. So that was cool to learn the remote some. And here I actually froze the screen, and you can see I just took out the main board. I unfroze the screen and the main board's out, but that's something cool too. So if you need to take a picture of it to show someone else, I inverted it here. So if you need to see circuits better, you can invert it. And just imagine if this isn't all circuits. You can use it for coins, you can use it for jewelry, you can put feathers under there. You can even use it for main boards. Now here I just flip the picture around. You can rotate the main board in case you need to see it from a different angle. So here I'm rotating it around multiple times for us to be able to see, which I think is really cool because you can use these in classrooms, show students. Again, I'm just playing around showing you how you can use contrast, brightening to make the image on the screen look different, even though what is under the microscope stays the same. So we're zooming in again, as if I wanted to look at that F301 fuse even closer to see something. Found it really cool. Now this also allows you to take pictures, as you can see. So now I just took a picture there, but now I pushed mode on my remote. I took a picture, but if my mode changes, that I'm in picture mode now, but previously I was in video mode. Now it changed to a little girl in a picture, so that's looking at the pictures I already took. So that's a previous photo, and you saw I had the main board in my hand there. So the main board's not actually on there, it's looking at a picture. Now we're back in video mode. This would be taking a video if I wanted to. Now we're in picture mode again. This is the previous picture I had taken, and now we're in video mode again. So you can transition through multiple modes in preview previous things. If you want to take a video, you press OK instead of mode. So now you can see that we have the video icon, but we also have the red numbers counting us up with the blinking red light. So now I know that we're in a video mode. If I needed to record myself trying to, say, fix the fuse, now we're back in picture mode. I pressed mode again. And now you see that there's a film instead of a video. So now we're looking back at the film that I actually just took. And if you press mode again, I believe when you're actually looking at things, that's where you can go and decide if you want to delete an item, put it into the slideshow. Now I'm back in that girl picture mode. So here's a little bit of back. I'm just showing you the remote. You could inverse the picture on the microscope, and it doesn't have to be a picture, it can just be what you're looking at. You can inverse something, and you can also zoom in, brighten the picture, or deepen the contrast. So there's many things that this microscope can do, and is very exciting to look at. And here's where I inversed it, and I zoomed in. I just thought multiple times that if this was in a classroom somewhere, you definitely could show to students something in particular that you're looking at. And here you can take more pictures, more videos. All right, the light box coming up, because similarly with how you powered on the light to your actual microscope, that's how you're going to power on the light to your light box. That's where you can put some of those slides that came with your actual microscope. So we'll switch over to that, and I'll go ahead and explain that. So here's one of the slides that came with the actual microscope package. And you can see that my light box is under the microscope, and I have it really close, but I'm also making sure that it's not touching the slide, so nothing scratches. So I took that one out. I'm going to put another slide in real quick. This is a pine cone, and here I just took a picture because I wanted to. I thought it was cool. I wanted to, and I wanted to invert it because it's fun. It really is. But I'll show you. That same little cable, it is going to be your third on the bottom of the switch cable, is what goes into your light box. So you'll see here. And then you can just stick that back into your microscope to light it up. So awesome. Thanks for watching this review.